In the previous session, we have studied the basic concept of biotechnology. We have also made an attempt to understand how the principles and processes of biotechnology have changed over a period of time from its traditional to modern form. We have concluded with a small overview of various areas of life and industry that have been impacted by modern biotechnology. Now, we will focus on few applications of biotechnology in agriculture and healthcare industry. Before we discuss these applications, let us understand the one basic concept which has enabled development of variety of biotechnological processes that are used in many applications of 21st century. It is termed as recombinant DNA technology. You have probably heard of a more common name used for the same, that is genetic engineering. By now, I am sure you have a clear understanding of how genes or DNA carries information and controls various structural and functional aspects of cells and in turn complete organism. Genetic engineering involves techniques using which genes from an organism belonging to one species can be transferred to an organism of another species. In this way, any desirable trait or character can be bestowed on chosen organism by genetically modifying it. Such genetically modified organisms are being used to produce commercially important products and services in food, agriculture, pharmaceutical, healthcare, chemical industry, as well as in offering better alternatives to the current technologies for combating pollution and managing our environment. Genetically modified organisms are also termed as transgenic organisms because they carry one or more genes that are naturally not part of their genome but have been transferred to them from different organism of other species. Thus, in your textbook, while reading about commercial applications of biotechnology, you will come across some examples wherein transgenic or genetically modified organisms are used to produce better crops, foods, medicines, etc. We will go over some of these examples in details. Let us start by studying some applications in the field of agriculture. The aim of agriculture is to produce good quality crop plants to supply nutritious grains, fruits, vegetables, etc., and provide good raw materials for textile and food processing industry. The quantity and quality of agriculture produce depends on factors like quality of seeds or seed plants, soil fertility, ample water supply, and protection of growing crop plants from pests. Biotechnology has helped improve the quality of crop plants with respect to nutritive content, better yields, as well as other agronomic characteristics like pest and environmental stress resistance. Some examples are discussed here. Golden rice. Rice is one of the most staple food crop cultivated and commonly consumed in India as well as all over the world. It is also inexpensive as compared to other food grains and forms major part of diet of most of the people from all economic backgrounds. The rice grain is rich in carbohydrate starch and unpolished grain also is good source of B complex vitamins. However, the all normal varieties of rice are deficient in other vitamins. Therefore, one area of research was if rice crop is fortified with any of these vitamins, then its nutritive value will improve and it can better solve the problem of malnourishment, especially prevalent in children of people from poor economic groups. With this in view, using genetic engineering, a new transgenic variety of rice was developed which carries gene from daffodil plant or soil bacteria Erwinia. This new gene introduced in rice plant enables production of beta carotene, a yellow pigment required for vitamin A formation in the grain of rice, giving it yellow color. Hence, the name of this transgenic rice is golden rice. It has better nutritive content than normal variety, and its consumption can reduce deficiency of vitamin A in poor children, which is major cause of night blindness. Thus, this is an example where biotechnology has helped to improve cropland by making it more nutritious. BT crops. The prefix BT stands for Bacillus thuringiensis. This is name of a bacterium which is responsible for causing disease and killing caterpillar of many insect pests that eat and harm standing crop plants in the field. This bacterium has a gene responsible for producing a toxin termed as BT toxin, which kills the pests. Using the techniques of recombinant DNA technology, this gene has been transferred to variety of crop plants like cotton, brinjal, corn, potatoes, etc. These transgenic plant containing gene for BT toxin produce the toxin, and when the pests like bollworm feed on this plant, the pest dies because of the BT toxin. Thus, the plant is rendered pest resistant and the need to use environment polluting chemical pesticide is minimized. Similarly, transgenic plants which are resistant to herbicides or weedicides have been produced. These plants are able to survive and grow well even in presence of chemicals which are used to kill other unwanted plants like certain grasses or weeds, etc., growing in fields. Transgenic plants with ability to fix nitrogen and solubilize phosphate have been developed using genetic engineering. Nitrogen and phosphorus are two important elemental nutrients which are necessary for plant growth. Fertile soils usually contain these elements in form of soluble compounds which are absorbed by the plant's roots along with water. But if these nutritive compounds are present in less amounts in the soil where crop plants are being cultivated, then chemical fertilizers are added to soil to increase its fertility. However, a prolonged use of chemical fertilizers is also responsible for soil and water pollution. Hence, use of microorganisms that are capable of fixing nitrogen from atmosphere and solubilizing phosphate was promoted to increase soil fertility. These are termed as biofertilizers. You have already studied examples of such microorganisms. With help of genetic engineering, desirable genes from these microbes are transferred to the crop plants, and thus the transgenic plants can themselves acquire required nitrogen and phosphorus easily from their surroundings. In this way, dependency on chemical fertilizers is greatly reduced. Apart from use of genetic engineering to develop transgenic plants, biotechnological applications in agriculture also involve use of plant tissue culture techniques. Varieties of fruits and vegetables of plants such as banana, papaya, grapes, lemon, potato, sweet potato, carrots, capsicum have been developed using tissue culture technology. Advantages offered by tissue culture of such commercially important crop plants is large-scale production in small space, development of fruits and vegetables with better shelf life, development of disease-free plants, development of seedless varieties of fruits and vegetables, to name a few.